Let us now study about interference of light. You might have studied the phenomena of interference and superposition of waves. Similar thing we are going to study about light waves. And similarly here for interference of light, we can write that when two coherent light waves superpose at a point, the resulting intensity, the resultant intensity at that point is different from some of the two intensities which are getting superposed. Some of the two intensities of individual waves. So, this modification in light intensity at the point of superposition of coherent waves. You must be very careful about the phenomena that for phenomena of interference to take place, waves must be coherent. So here we can write this modification of superposition of coherent waves is called interference of light. And in some situation, like say if there is a source 1, there is a source 2 which are producing light waves and these are coherent. We already studied about coherent waves. These are the waves which are having exactly same phase, constant frequency and zero initial time lag between the sources, or constant initial phase difference between the two waves. Such sources are called coherent sources, and the waves emitted by these sources are called coherent waves. So, if this is a point of superposition, there are some points where resulting intensity becomes maximum and there are some points where resulting intensity becomes minimum. So, the points where intensity is maximum are called points of constructive interference and the points where resulting intensity becomes minimum are called points of destructive interference. In coming sections, we are going to analyze mathematically about the intensity of light at the point of superposition in terms of individual intensities as well as the phase difference between the two waves at the point of superposition. Let's continue in detail with the theory of interference from the coming section.